नमस्कार, आई एम डॉक्टर संतोष पांडे फ्रॉम द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ योगा एंड नेचुरोपैथी। सो टुडे व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस, बेसिकली वी टॉक एंड वी डिस्कस अ लॉट अबाउट योगा एंड नेचुरोपैथी, बट वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड एग्जैक्टली व्हाट इज द बेसिस एंड व्हाट इज द फिलॉसफी ऑन विच इट इज बेस्ड this both the systems. So we all know that yoga and naturopathy are two different aspects of the same coin basically. So the treatment part, what we plan in yoga and naturopathy, basically it is called panchkosha theory or five sheath theory it is called. So now I'm going to integrate basically these two systems, because we have to understand the importance of these two systems together. So what happens whenever a patient approaches to a physician who is a yoga naturopathy graduate? So what is the exact picture, what the doctor thinks before planning the treatment? Now here we all have to understand that we have five layers, which is called panchkoshas, which I have already written. And this panchkoshas, the external, the most grossest form of your being is called annamaya kosha, or the physical body. Now this physical body is basically your anatomical body, which is supported or nourished by the food. That's why it is also called annamaya kosha. Now annamaya kosha is again supported with the help of pranamaya kosha, where there is a flow of prana, nadis, chakras, all those things are present at pranamaya kosha. And subtler to pranamaya kosha is your manomaya kosha, which is called mental sheath. Now mental sheath, basically in yoga and in naturopathy, both the systems, they believe very clearly that every disease originates in the mind. So whenever you have stress, whenever you have any negative emotions or anything negative, immediately its impact will be there on the pranamaya kosha, and then you will see at the level of physical body or annamaya kosha will have the symptoms. Then subtler to this manomaya kosha is your intellectual body, which is called vijnanamaya kosha. And once you balance these four sheets of your existence, you are in the bliss body or the anandamaya kosha. So now we will just understand with the help of this concept when it started, basically whether it we have any reference or not. So in Taittiriya Upanishad there is a reference of panchkoshas, and if you read Yog Vashishth explains about the ailments or diseases. Now diseases, they have classified diseases which are born because of mind and which are born without the active involvement of the mind. Now diseases which are formed because of the involvement of the mind are called adhija vyadhis. So where there is an involvement of mind, so you can say negative emotions, thoughts or stress, anything it can be. So because of that, what happens, there is an imbalance in your normal mental status, and because of that what will happen, there is a blockage or there is an improper flow of prana inside your nadis at the pranamaya kosha. And once pranamaya kosha is disturbed, so you will see the symptoms at your physical level in a form of increased blood pressure, heart rate, pulse rate, all the vitals will be changed. So now suppose when you understand that mind is the main reason where all these things are happening, so what will be the management, how you are going to correct these things? So management in yoga and naturopathy, we start with the mind directly. So what are things you can do to heal your mind, or to, you can say, reach the nirodhavastha, where you don't have any negative or positive any thoughts, you are balanced totally. So there are techniques, there are meditation techniques which can be given to the patient or to the normal person, which can heal the mind. So I will just list out some few meditation techniques which will help you out in this. So the first thing what we recommend is yoga nidra. So yoga nidra has got a very powerful modality which directly affects your mind, and it calms down the mind because it stimulates your parasympathetic nervous system. So Yog Nidra is one system. Then we have chakra meditation, which balances all the chakras. We have Nada Anusandhan. We have Bhakti Yoga. So these all the things, no, they do emotional culture at the same time. It affects the mind also. So once your mind is balanced, automatically you will see its impact will be there on the prana. Now, if you want, suppose there is, because of some stress, your pranamaya kosha is imbalanced totally. Now for the mind you have done. Now pranamaya kosha, what you are going to do? So pranamaya kosha, there is no medicine available on the planet which can heal the pranamaya kosha or correct the nadis of the chakras. So what can be done? There is only one system which can help you, that is yoga. So research based yogic practices for the particular disease. Like suppose you have a hypertension. So you will be doing the cooling practices, cooling pranayamas you will be doing, nadi shuddhi you will be doing to balance this 72,000 nadis and the chakras inside it. So once this two we have done, now at the physical level we have lot of practices. Like for physical level we have from the modern medical system till Ayush, everything comes which can work at your physical level. So for the physical level in yoga we have asanas, bandhas, mudras, kriyas, all these things along with that naturopathy treatments and any other modality which is available can only heal your physical body, but it can never reach to the pranamaya kosha or the subtler body or the manomaya kosha. And for once, suppose these three are balanced, now you have to think about balancing your intellect also, because unless and until your intellect is balanced, what will happen? Your mind may fluctuate with the situations around it. So what you can do, your intellect, once you want to balance, so Ishwar Pranidhan and Swadhyaya, self-study of the scriptures and total surrenderance to supreme energy. So once you do that, automatically you will see that all the four levels of the four koshas will be balanced. And once these four levels are balanced, naturally you are in the fifth level, which is called bliss body or Anandamaya kosha. So this is the basic concept of yoga therapy and the naturopathy. And that is the reason these two systems are combined and it is practiced. So I think for today this is sufficient. Namaskar.